Okay, have you ever been to the skating rink at the Marina Bay Sands? Yes,
No.
and of course, the surface of the skating rink is made of, not yet, me too, not yet, never go abroad, only stay in Batam. Instead of ice, the surface of the skating rink is made of an artificial material called polyethylene. Yeah, you still remember the ethylene from the previous school year, semester 2? What is an ethylene? Yeah, actually, ethylene is an alkene. This ethylene. Okay, let's recall ethylene. An alkene, yeah, F, yeah, meaning consists of two carbon atoms. Alkene is consists of at least one double, an alkene, yeah, at least consists of double carbon bond. So this is the structure formula of ethenes. Because carbon has four hands, yes, it means these carbon atoms, yeah, attach with another two hydrogen atoms. This is ethene. And then poly means many. Yeah, poly means many. So we can't make polyethene from ethene. Yeah, when we react the ethene with another ethene. Yeah, polyethylene has a very large molecular size. It is about 800,000 carbon atom per molecules. Yeah, what properties makes polyethylene suitable for making skating ring? Yeah, let's looking at the subtopic 24.1 and 24.2. Yeah, for the subtopic 24.1 macromolecules, we have one learning outcome. Yeah, meaning at the end of the lesson, you should be able to describe the structure of macromolecules. And then the subtopic 24.2 addition polymerizations. Yeah, in this sections, you should be able to describe the addition polymerization of ethenes from polyethylene. Yeah, to form polyethylene and deduce the structure of polymer from its monomer and vice versa and set some use of polyethylene. Let's start from the subtopic 24.1 macromolecules. Yeah, these pictures shows animation of macromolecules that some small molecule combines with another small molecules joining together to form macromolecules. Macromolecules, yeah, what is the meaning of macromolecules? Yeah, macromolecules is a very large molecule that is made up of many small molecules. The food that we eat, yeah, such as egg, bread, yeah, is made up of many small molecules. Yeah, the proteins is large molecules. Yeah, made up from the basic functional unit that also known as the amino acids. Proteins, yeah, the basic functional unit of protein is amino acids. Yeah, we have learned it from biology subject. For the carbohydrates, yeah, the basic unit of carbohydrates, yeah, also known as the simple sugar. Yeah, it can be glucose, galactose, or fructose. Yeah, glucose, like fructose, galactose, yeah, is the simple sugar, and also lipids. Is a sample example of macromolecules, yeah, the large molecules that has the simplest unit is fatty acid and glycerol. Yeah, when the small molecule like amino acids, yeah, it will join together to become the large molecule, they're also known as the proteins. So the proteins is a kind of macromolecules. Yeah, proteins, carbohydrates, lipids, yeah, are the example of macromolecules. And also the clothes we wear are made of a very large molecule. They're also called as the macromolecules. For example, the silk, a macromolecule come from the cocoon of the silkworm. Yeah, made of macromolecules. And then let's discuss about the polymer. Yeah, what is a polymer? And this is the diagram that shows how to make polymer from monomer. What is monomer? What is polymer? Yeah, mono means one. Yeah, mono means one. And poly means many. Mer is a unit. Yeah. Monomer, so we can call the monomer as the many small molecules. Monomers, yeah, monomer, only one unit, monomers, yeah, many small molecules. And how about polymer? Is one large molecule. After the monomer combined with another, yeah, when the monomer combined with another monomer, directions to combine monomers, yeah, also known as the polymerizations. And then the conditions for polymerizations, yeah, is a high temperature and pressure. That is the conditions during the reactions. Yeah, monomer is a molecule that can react together with other monomer molecule to form a larger polymer chain. Yeah, the small molecules monomer combine with another monomer. Yeah, in polymerizations, that the conditions in high temperature and pressure, T is temperature, P, high pressure, yeah, make up the polymer. What is a polymer? It's a long chain macromolecule that's linked together by many small monomers. Monomer combines with another monomer to become a polymer. And then the reactions, yeah, is polymerizations. Yeah, is the process of joining together a large number of monomer to form a polymer. This is some example of natural and synthetic polymers. Natural polymer, yeah, such as proteins, is natural polymers. DNA, deoxyribonucleic acids. Nucleic acids, yeah, also the polymers, yeah, starch, cellulose, yeah, wool, natural rubber, and silk. Yeah, this is the example of natural polymers. And how about the synthetic? Yeah, we can make the synthetic polymer in the laboratory. Yeah, like polyethylene. Yeah, when we combine ethylene with another ethylene, polyethylene, nylon, terylene, PVC, yeah, polyvinyl chloride, polyvinyl acetate, Teflon, and polystyrene. Yeah, this is the synthetic, yeah, made from the chemical. in the laboratorium. Teflon also, that used for cooking. Teflon is a synthetic polymer. The proteins in an egg is a natural polymer. And then this picture shows PVC. Actually, it is not wood. It's PVC, polyvinyl chloride. Yeah, synthetic polymer. Okay, any question, the student? Until this slide about the subtopic 24.1 macromolecules.
None.
Can we? Okay, let's go to the next slide, yeah. 24.2 addition, polymerizations. Yeah, what is monomers and polymers? This is the example. What is it? What is the structure? What is the name of this structure? Actually, the green color represent carbon. Is it carbon? The yellow color represent hydrogens. Yeah, two carbon atoms and four hydrogen atoms. Yeah, from the previous chapter, yeah, you have learned, is it an ethene? Yeah, two carbon atom, one double bond, carbon-carbon double bond, and four hydrogen atom is ethene, an alkene. Is it ethene? Yeah, ethene is called as the S monomer because, yeah, it is just one small molecule. Yeah, we can use ethene to make plastics. For the first step, yeah, what happened with the ethene? Yeah, the double bond of ethene, yeah, break down into the single bond. This is double bond, breakdowns into single bond. Yeah, because there is no double bond, yeah, so it means the hands of the carbons, yeah, will change here. Yeah, it's why the ethene can combine with another ethene, yeah, because they have the new hands, yeah, to combine with another carbon. The carbon from this ethene can combine with another carbon from another ethene, because the double bond, yeah, break down into the single bond. And then the next step, yeah, add the molecule together at high temperature and pressure. This is the condition that we need, high temperature and pressure. Yeah, the single bond, two carbon atom and four hydrogen atom combine with another, combine each other to form the long chain. The long chains, also known as the polymer. This is the monomer. Monomer, yeah, the monomer is ethene. Monomer combine to form polymer. This is polymer. The long chains of hydrocarbons, polyethene. This molecule is called polyethene. Yeah, poly means many, many ethene, because ethene combine with another ethene. And then the process known as the polymerizations that need high temperature and pressure. Okay, another way of drawing it, okay, instead of circle, let's use letter. Yeah, the ethene, what is the structure formula of ethene? Yeah, let's write the structure formula of ethene. Yeah, one double bond, four hydrogen atoms. is joined with another ethene, one double bond, four hydrogen atoms. Yeah, it's an ethene. Now, so it's ethene. Ethene. Joined together, yeah, to become the long chain of hydrocarbon, because we have 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 4 carbon atoms, and then the double bond chains into the single bond, double bond into single bond, so there's also the bond between carbon and carbon, the new bond. The new bond, yeah, 4 hydrogen atoms for 2 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 4 hydrogen atoms for 2 carbon, 1, 2, 3, and 4. This is polyethenes. Yeah, more than one means poly or many ethene. And what is the general formula for addition polymerizations? Yeah, for ethene, for example, ethene. The carbon double bond. Yeah, N, number of, yeah, this is, N shows total number of the ethene, or total number of monomer. Total number of monomer. So the products, yeah, show us the single bond, the double bond changes into single bond, and also this is the end. Yeah, total number of the monomer is same. This is the general formula for addition polymerizations. This is for ethene. How about propene? Propene. What is the structure formula of propene?
Structure itu yang C sama H itu ya?
Like this. Nah, this is structure formula. Let's try for propene. How many carbon atom? That's propene have?
Three,
right? 1, 2, and 3. Yeah, because we have one double bond. Yeah, 4 carbon atoms. So it means, yeah, it should be like this. CH3. Is propene. Yeah, and total number of propene join together, the products, yeah, it should be single bond. The double bond changes into single bond. CH3. And this is the general formula for propene. Okay. For the addition polymerization, addition means, yeah, breakdowns the double bond and changes it into single bonds. Additions.
Miss, how about butene?
Butene.
Yes.
Butene same. Yeah, butene is double bond, right? CH3 is butene. Only the double bonds breakdowns. This one. Yeah, N number of butene breakdowns and combine together to form the polymer. Yeah, polybutene. CH3. The total is N. Okay. The concept only break down the double bond. and change it into single pole. Next.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, this is the questions on polymers. Yeah, complete the table by filling in the names of the missing monomer and polymer. What is the name of monomer polyethylene?
Ethene.
Can you draw the full structure formula of ethene? Yeah, F. Yeah, consists of 2 carbon atoms, 1 double bond, and 4 hydrogen atom. This is ethene. For example. And what is the name of polymer from propene?
Polypropene.
Yeah, polypropene. It's easy to give the name. Polypropene. What is the name of monomer polystyrene? Polystyrene.
Styrene.
Yeah, styrene. How about chloroethene? What is the name of the polymer from the monomer chloroethene?
The structure for styrene.
Structure of styrene.
Yes.
The structure of styrene. Actually, styrene is a cyclic hydrocarbon. It's like benzene. It's a cyclic. It's benzene. This is the formula of cyclic hydrocarbon. And then we break down the double bond into single bond. We can break this double bond and then joining together. It will become polystyrene. Combine with another. Yeah, long change. The new. This is polystyrene. This is the monomer, right? Styrene joining with another styrene, polystyrene. Okay. Next, yeah, deducing the structure formula of a monomer from its polymer. There are 3 steps. The first step, yeah, identify the repeat unit in the polymer. Yeah, can you identify what is the repeat unit from this polypropylene? Polypropylene. What is the monomer? The repeat unit. Yeah, we can identify, right? From this. Can be like this. No, right? Because it's not same with the next. So the unit, the monomer should be
the CH should be in the middle.
CH2, CH, and CH3. This is the monomer, right? Because repeat. This is the monomer, same, right? So should be the monomer. Propylene. Monomer. Identify repeat unit the polymer. This is the repeat unit. CH2, CH, CH3. Write down the formula of the repeat unit. The formula of repeat unit CH2, CH3. And then convert the carbon-carbon single bond into carbon-carbon double bond.
And
convert it.
Convert the carbon single bond
into double bond. Yeah. So the single bond will change into double bond. One, two, three, four. That is just the monomer. Okay. This is the monomer from the polypropylene. This is the monomer. CH through double bond CH, CH3. And the uses of addition polymer, such as polyethylene. This is polyethylene. Polyphenyl chloride, polystyrene, polypropene. There's some uses of the polymers. Polyethylenes, have the properties. Very cheap, strong, and easy module, and long-lasting, durable polymer. Long-lasting, strong, and easily molded. They use this like plastic bags, bottles, buckets, and also for toys. PVC, the pipe, the PVC. Also have the characteristic strong, hard and flexible. Polystyrene, styrofoam. Is made of the polystyrene styrofoam. And polypropene, also for the bottles, funnels, that resistant to high temperature. So who can answer our starting questions? Why in the Singapore use polystyrene for making skating ring? Who knows? What property makes polyethylene is suitable for making skating ring?
Because it connects.
Because it's connect.
Yeah.
How about the properties? The polyethylene. Strong, right? What are the other properties? Strong. Because it's polymer, right? Polymer combined from monomers. One monomer combined with another monomer. So the properties of polyethylene is strong, long-lasting. It's why it's used for making skating ring. Karena sepatu skating itu dari ada pisaunya kan, sangat tajam. So we need the strong materials. We need the long lasting materials. That's why not covered only, not only covered by the ice, but also covered by the polyethylene, the skating ring.
Dia ada maintenance nggak, Miss?
Maintenance apa?
Maintenance kayak diperbaiki mungkin.
Yes, actually, actually need. Oh. Is about how many years need maintains skating ring. Even it's long lasting, it's like pipe also need to renewable, right? To maintains our sanitary. Another question, the student. Concern about the macromolecules and addition polymerization. It's like Tupperware, also made from the polymer. Yeah, so many materials around us made from polymers. Yeah, phone case, pen, our bag also made from the polymers. Plastic. Okay, let's continue to the summary questions. Yeah, plastic are made out of large molecule called, let's fill in the blank. What is the correct answer?
Polymers.
Yeah, polymers. We make this by joining together lots of small molecule called
monomers.
Yeah, monomers. Yeah, one example of a plastic is polyethylene made from
ethylene.
Yeah, ethylene. Polyethylene is formed as a result of an, what is the name
addition
of reactions? Yeah, addition. Addition polymerization reaction. Addition. The type of addition is polymerization. So it means we can make a conclusion. What is mean by the addition polymerization reaction? What is the meaning of addition polymerization reaction? Addition means, yeah, breakdowns the double bond into single bond. Polymerization, yeah, meaning to make up the polymer from the monomer. Yeah, joining together the monomers to become the long chain polymer. Yeah, draw a propane molecule. What is the propane molecule? Yeah, we
propane.
Have propane, 3 carbon atom, right?
Yes.
3 carbon atom, 1 double bond, CH3, CH2, CH. This is the propane molecule. And then we draw a diagram to show how propane molecule join together to form polypropane. CH2, CH3, and number of propene joined together to become it will change into single bond. CH3, this is H joining together with another. For example, the total number of is 3. We can write like this one. H. 1, 2, 3. H. It's 3. And H. This is the polypropene. And then, remember we need the high temperature and pressure.
We need wait.
Temperature and pressure. This is simple. The general formula we can write it. Yeah.
Why only C in the middle?
Only C in the middle.
Only
which
three.
One? Only three. Yeah, because I give the example. Total number of monomer is 3. 1, 2, 3, and then it will be continue.
Maksudnya tengahnya itu, tengahnya itu yang C.
C yang di tengah itu kurang satu tangan.
C yang di tengah. Oh, H. Forget H. 1, 2, 3, H. Also H.
Oh iya iya.
Iya iya iya. So sorry ya. It will be H. H. That is H. Yeah, we can write the general formula and it's 2 C CH CH3 changes into single bond. CH3. Oh no, no more hands. Yeah, number N, also known as the polypropene. Yeah, explain the polymerization reaction in B. Yeah, we break down the double molecule from the monomer propene, and then the propene joining together with another propene become the polymer, the long chain polymer. And then the condition that we need is high temperature and pressure for the reaction. Okay, Dan? Any question, dear student? Any concern? Randy, Jolin? Dewi Lestari?
No, miss.
No?
Yeah.
Okay. How about Dewi?
No, miss.
No? Okay, I think it's enough lah ya, dear students. Let's end this meeting. See ya for the next subject ya. Yeah?